So, hello, welcome back. Today the video should have been new records. But I got two deliveries this week and somehow there were some points where I said, I don't like that. I don't like a certain development and doesn't give me a good feeling. And I thought about putting these things into this new record video, but then I thought, hey, come on, that doesn't mix together very well. And so I decided to do a video about the things that I dislike by on its own. So where we go through these things that annoys me and get rid of them and look for the new records video on Tuesday. The video will be in four segments with different aspects of, in a way, the same problem, and I hope at the end of the video you may get my point, what strikes me about this releases. I want to start with an edition I got 2 days ago, and which shows the first or some of the aspects I dislike. Some of you ask me in the comments, why don't you do a video about ECM? And sometimes I say, yeah, why not? Why not? I have some ECMs. I should do a video, but I'm out of ECM in a way for several reasons, which are not the topic of today. But then I saw that there will be this release. The Keith Jarrett Sunbear Concerts, a 10 album box set of the original recordings in Japan, 10 discs, all analog. Not bad. I ordered it, got it very quick here in Germany, and then it came. To say it right in the beginning, the record sounds okay, decent mastering, decent vinyl, nothing spectacular, but nothing bad. It's, as I said, an analog mastering process. You really get the atmosphere of the concert hall. All good. But then let's look to the details. This is how you get it. You know, Keith Jarrett is the artist from ECM. I'm quite sure. If you ask them and tell what's your most important artist, they probably say Keith Jarrett. And then you get this box set. Everything is in paper, and you don't get a slip case where you put this box set in. You get this piece of paper. You get a piece of paper to cover the 10 records. You get a booklet. Okay, thank you. Nice booklet. It's okay. Then you have here, you have your records in like a book. But come on, there is something like linen. There are some things like slip cases. I know you can say this is maybe because this one has been out several years ago. Maybe they orientated on that one, but come on, we are decades later now. If this release is so important that you put it out again, and that you put out 2,000 copies, give us a more beautiful cover. Show us that you care about this stuff, that you go into the details and think about it. And I mean, we are not talking about a 120 € box, we are talking 260 plus euros, plus shipping. So this is around 300, with shipping, $350. Give a little more attention to these kind of releases and don't give us this instead of a beautiful slipcase or something like that. And you know, I go through some negative sides in this video, but I always took out a positive as an antipode in a way. And I show you this release. And we are talking the same price class. It's not more expensive, it's the same price class. There is a label, a one-man show. This guy, Frank Bull, from Vinyl on Demand, does all by himself, a one-man show. He puts out 4 to 6 editions per year, and he gave us the Soviet France catalog. There's 1-2 box sets out already, there will be a third, and he puts them into this handmade wooden boxes. You know? That's a way to present a box set edition. And then, not only this beautiful wooden box, the releases. All in a single cover, beautiful, sometimes on white vinyl. All are 180 gram vinyls, not like the Keith Jarrett, around 140, 150 gram vinyl. Pressed over, of course, pressed over at Palace. You even, here are the rest of the albums. Let's go through them. Gorgeous cover, love for the detail. That's what at least I want. I want love for the detail, that you can feel how important this release is to the label. You even get a t-shirt. Come on, it's not that important, but he gives us a t-shirt. Same price range. 500 pieces has been done from this vinyl edition. That's, you know, that's quite the opposite. Lack of interest, lack of detail, and the opposite. Love for the product itself. To give the customer the feeling, here you have something important. We love what we do. I don't get that from this Keith Jarrett box set. It's okay, don't get me wrong. It's not a bad edition, but lacks feeling, love, and detail. So that's with the Keith Jarrett box set. Then earlier this week, and I already made a video about it, so we don't go so deep into it, I've got my Lush Life Coltrane Craft box set. The outer case, good idea, nice design with this plastic. Okay, well made. But then the cover, wrong. Here you have the analog production, which is like the original. Wrong blue color. The hand, the ratio of the photograph. Wrong. Why? Then there are quite some people who doesn't get a numbered copy. Why? Come on. The box it was shipped in, terrible. The cover, not shiny, nothing special, without love, without care, no feeling for the detail. I do not understand why. If you put out a new series, this is the first edition, you only put out 1,000. For marketing reasons. Why not care for detail? Why don't you love your product? I don't understand it. You know, for the positive examples, how you can do those kind of editions right, and there are several examples how you can do these things right. I took out this, for example, the UHQR Jimi Hendrix Experience from Analog Production. Beautiful, beautiful case, you know. Chad Kassim got inspired by these old classical releases where you have this wooden part which is round, beautiful, beautiful package, beautiful gatefold cover, really well, excuse me, really well, beautiful made. That's what we want, love for the product. Another example how you can do this one steps or UHQR's edition, right? Perfect example, Impex record, outer case, beautiful linen, and then the record itself, fantastic gatefold cover with a three disc edition, beautiful. Beautiful. That's what we want to see. Beauty, care for the product, details. And you know, Impex isn't such a large company, but they care. They think about it. What can we do? What do the collectors want if we take that amount of money? You know, maybe you've seen my video with Danny and my video with Ewe Von from Impex. There you get the feeling, same with Shane Büttner from Intervention. They are really into this stuff. They love what they do, and they care about it. Great. Now all the larger, bigger companies go into this stuff by themselves, and so far, I like it more up to now. Maybe they change. Up to now, I like it much more when those companies like Analog Productions, Impex, Interventions, Sam Records goes so deep into the details and does as a one-man show, so beautiful releases. I hope that they do it, that they still do it, and that the big guns, the big companies don't take that away and go on their own, because so far, not so good. You know, there's another example where a big company does it right. Give me a second, where have I put those? Here. An example where a big company does it right, and this is Blue Note with the tone poles. So what happened with the tone poles, and what is the difference when it comes to the tone poles? The difference, in my opinion, is that Don Was did something very interesting and something very intelligent. He bought human resources in a way. He contacted Ron Harley from Music Matters, one of those companies, smaller companies, who has done it right, perfectly right, and said, can you do something like that for us? So in a way, he bought the knowledge of Music Matters. And what we got now from Blue Note in the Tone Poet series is Music Matters 2.0. Same covers from Stoughton, the session photos, the mastering from Kevin Gray, and we got a next to perfect product. Beautiful, beautiful. That's what at least I want, a product that I like. You get it and you open it, you smell it, the crackling, the photos, the shiny cover, the glossy cover, the pressing, the vinyl quality from RTI. Great. They bought the knowledge from Harley, and now they are doing a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful series. On the other hand, same company, same musician, again Blue Note, the classic series. So, a lot of talk. I know. We talked a lot about the classic series, and the main argument was, you know, you don't get the cover, you don't get the session photos, you get simpler covers, even don't get an inner sleeve which is appropriate, but you get it cheap. $22, €22. And why do we do that? Because that was the main argument that I've heard so far. We want to attract new people into jazz music. We need a broader audience. We want to get the younger people. But okay, what happens? They want new customers with these releases. But I think, how can I get a new customer? A new customer is somebody who doesn't know that record. Otherwise, it's not a new customer. If he knows, oh yeah, it's great, I buy that. It's not a new customer, he already knows it. So they want to reach the people who don't know it. But how can I reach them with a boring product, with an average product? I don't get that, because if this release is in a record store, it's one of many. And there is nothing which makes that one special to me. It's an average cover, on average vinyl, and why? I think I can attract more people with a product, and I don't know, and say, oh, that's like the Tone Poets. So I think that they reach more new customers through the Tone Poets than through the classic series. But don't get me wrong, boring, not the music. This is the cream, of course. In the classic series, we have the cream, the top releases. But then again, I am not so sure that this is the best possible strategy. The last part is when it comes to, in a way, re-releases of a catalog from important artists. And once more, and for the last time, the terrible Rolling Stones, sometimes terrible Rolling Stones releases, at least when it comes to the Sticky Fingers from Abbey Road, the Half-Speed Masters, and the, let's call them, the mediocre Half-Speed Masters from Bob Marley. Again, no love for the product, no love for the detail, no love for the importance, for the magnitude of the albums they are allowed to remaster and put them out to the people. Again, a big company, Abbey Road, one of the biggest disappointments in the last year for me. And again, there are examples of other important artists where you have quite the opposite. And again, they care, they look for the detail. With every ounce of their releases, you feel that they take care, that they look into the detail, that they love their product. And those are, for example, the Zappa Trust releases, in this case the Sheikh Djibouti. Fantastic sounding album. They take so much care for their product. It's sheer beauty. Or for example, the vault master of the Zappa Trust, he wrote a comment on my video, below my video. Why? Because they look out, they care, they are interested. You know, that's the difference. Another artist who cares, who puts out fantastic audiophile releases from its catalog, is Neil Young. Beautiful, all analog releases. The Zappa Trust, in a lot of cases, they do the releases, the remasters from Chris Bellman or Bernie Grundman. Fantastic sounding, beautiful releases. They care, they love their product. So now I feel better. I really need to talk about that. Sorry. I hope I didn't bore you. What's your opinion? Am I too far out there? Do I take this stuff too serious? Maybe, probably, I don't know. But anyhow, thank you for your time. Hope to see you on my next video. Bye.